Hey everyone, it's Steve here with the Fragrance First Impressions video, and today I'm taking a look at Kinski and also Cuirs by Carner Barcelona. So I'll admit this is like not really a first impressions video. I did film me smelling both of these for the first time about a month ago, but I've just been lazy and haven't got around to actually kind of editing that video. So in its place I'm just doing this because I went on and waffled on a bit, so I'm just going to keep this a bit more concise. So Kinski, I bought this on eBay used for about £50. I've had my eye on it for a long time. I think I've been mainly attracted to it for that weed note that it's known for, as well as things like castoreum and vetiver. So I've been interested in wanting that for a long time, and then I saw it on eBay, so I went up and purchased it. And I think it was Red Essences review of this that made me want to sample it. So I bought a 3ml sample for £5. So I'll cut now to my first impressions of them, and yeah, let's see what this is all about then. Right. Okay, yeah, I can see why there's a black Afghan similarity. It must be that oud at the start. Oh, that's actually very similar. Very similar, like it's dark and strong and really refined at the same time. Oh, that's gorgeous. So, right, I've smelled that first one. I'm going to kind of not smell again. I will come back onto it in a few. So this was used. That's it. So Kinski. So it's quite a cool bottle. I've had this on my want list for Fragrantica for months and months. And I think it has maybe castoreum or civet as well. And it's kind of meant to be really dark and very like, I don't know. So this cost me £50, or just below £50. Here it is. Okay. Definitely no weed. Actually, it's quite green. Definitely, there's a grassy smell at the start. I was thinking patchouli, maybe. There's maybe similarities to Antaeus, perhaps, in terms of what I'm thinking of. Oh, now there's definite darkness coming through now. Antaeus is the very, very first thing I thought of there. Oh, that's so similar to Black Afghano. Like, there's no sort of smell of weed in that, but there's definitely just this denseness, you know. Like, here's my Black Afghano sample. And yeah, it just has a very similar feeling, you know. It must be the oud and woods in there, but oh, it's gorgeous. And Kinski now. I can faintly smell some weed, but I'll be honest, even after smelling it here, this seems quite light. Oh, that's interesting. It's not a very... not like as unusual as I expected it to be. It's not like, I'm not sure what I had in mind. I thought it was going to be just a very strange smell, but it's not that peculiar. I'm not sure. So yeah, it's been about a month now since I filmed that video, so I can give you a bit more thoughts. Not exactly a full review because I'm still not too adjusted to the scent. So I'll start off with Cuirs. So I really like this. I feel it's a bit more versatile than Black Afghano due to the lack of that kind of hashy note. I think it could be more like easy to wear. Like, I don't find that Black Afghano stinks of green and weed necessarily, but there's a subtlety to it, so you wouldn't really want to smell like that in particular environments, I don't think. But yeah, this is a really good scent. It has amazing longevity. I think I sprayed a little bit on my hand and it lasted for 12 hours easily. I'm not too sure about projection, but I have worn it once or twice. I kind of wear one spray and I felt like that, one spray at the chest, and I felt like it was creating a nice bubble around me for like an hour or two. So for a small little squirt, you know, it shows how strong that fragrance is. Kinski, on the other hand, I don't really know what to think of this, to be honest. I like it, but I don't love it. I kind of went into it just really expecting to really like it. but I'm not sure. The scent actually makes me feel a little nauseous. When I was wearing it like a few nights ago, I'd put two sprays on or three sprays, and literally, man, the comparison I can give you is like sort of as a kid, you know, or young adult, smoking weed and whatnot. And over here in Britain, we used to get this hash, which we used to call Rocky, and it was terrible. You know, it had like all sorts of nasty chemically shit in there. And this one time I smoked too much, and then it was kind of a known thing of whitey, where you basically just go really pale and you just feel very sick, and it's an unpleasant experience. And wearing Kinski kind of reminded me of that at times. I also find there's not that strong. I'm not sure, it might just be me, or I think this is kind of filled with ISO E Super, which is kind of known for kind of coming and going, you know, so the scent doesn't appear to be there all the time. But I'm not sure. But in terms of the similarity to that, I've recently acquired Encre Noir, and there's a very strong similarity between these two. Like I said, this reminds me of Antaeus, possibly the Castoreum Nort, and the Vertiver, and just this kind of like fizziness. I don't know, like I've only worn Encre Noir once or twice, but I find this is very strong, and it just has this kind of fizziness. It's a weird way to describe it, but that's the feeling I get, and it's similar in this, you know. I'm not sure, like, I'm probably going to keep this, you know. I need to wear it more to see how it's going to perform. I've worn it in colder seasons, which I think is what people are saying is the best time for it. I haven't worn it to the office, but I think I am. And, like, with the weed note in here, yeah, there's definitely a strong smell of it. And it reminds me of sticky bud, basically, you know. It's not like the smell of burning weed, but just kind of, if you had weed on your fingers and you're going to smell that, it's a very similar scent to that. So I don't know, I'm surprised that I don't love it as much as I do, but to be honest, I don't think wearing it more is going to really change that. Like, I don't know, let's try. Like, I like the scent, but I'm just a bit gutted that it hasn't really wowed me in the way that I felt like it was going to. So, it's really similar to not, really, really similar to Encre Noir. I mean, it's got different nuances. I mean, this doesn't have any notes, and this does, but the overall vibe and kind of feel of it is very similar. And again, in terms of this compared to Black Afghano, they are quite similar, but I think I prefer this, to be honest. I mean, it's cheaper as well, you know, you're going to get more volume when you buy a bottle of this. But to be honest, I don't really see myself purchasing it. This sample will last me a long time. Like, one spray is enough. Plus, I've got like 25 decants. You know, I'm not going to kind of blast through this necessarily. So that's kind of my overall first impressions of this. You know, it's probably 5 out of 10, to be honest. This is bordering like a 9. Yeah, this is a really strong, amazing, lovely scent, you know. And I'd actually say it's pretty good value, even though it's expensive. Like, it's got good projection and longevity. I think I'm kind of steering towards cheaper scents nowadays and becoming a bit more of a snob. Not entering niche territory necessarily, but kind of up in my fragrance game a little bit. So thank you for watching, guys, and until the next video, take care and have a great day, night, evening, all that stuff, and goodbye.